Hi, good evening viewers. My name is Ravi Teja. I am Senior Immigration Consultant working with Aussizz Group's Dubai branch. Today I am on Facebook Live to discuss on the eligibility criteria and the minimum requirement of Australia PR processing. As for the PR processing, basically it's a points-based system which is included based on your qualification and experience requirement. When we say to apply for the Australian immigration purpose, we have two visas which are involved in this one, which are permanent visas program nation. One is 189 independent migration, another is state nomination. These are the two subclass visas which basically gives us a PR. Under these two programs, we have the minimum eligibility requirement, which is to be based on your qualification and experience criterias. This is purely based on points-based system, where if we have an eligibility and the minimum experience requirement met, we can file under this PR program. When I say the minimum eligibility requirement, which is based on your number of years of experience and your age, your qualification, and the most important requirement is your English speaking score, which can be IELTS or Pearson Academic or TOEFL or Cambridge, which can be considered under English liability for Australia PR. Well, once we have the minimum requirement and once we meet this points criteria, we have to initiate a process under skill assessment or a stage called skill assessment process. Under this PR, once we get the eligibility criteria, we would file up your or we will start up your application under the points-based system criteria, where the first one is skill assessment as a part of a process. This basically, this both visas are divided into two groups or two subclass visas, as I mentioned in my initial startup of the video. When we file up for the nomination, or the first would be the skill assessment, which is the first part of the skill assessment for the immigration purpose, where under applying for this visa, the first stage is called as a skill assessment, where the skill assessment has the requirement based on your qualification and experience. When we say experience and qualification, today I'm here on live to tell you about the major and demanded occupation, which is electronic trade workers. This is a trade profession for the skilled visa, where people who have an experience under trade workers, like the experience under electronic trade equipment trade workers or instrumental trade workers, are the specialized occupations under this trade workers. Well, if you have an experience in related to this field, I would be explaining it to you the minimum eligibility for skill assessment, which is the first stage of the PR processing. Under this PR processing, when we file up your skill assessment, there is a minimum eligibility requirement also which you have to meet to file for the skill assessment, which is the minimum level of qualification as well as the number of years of experience. Now, when we say electronic trade workers, it is based on the skill which has the minimum requirement of diploma qualification, which is for 3 years. Along with diploma, 3 years of qualification, you would also meet the minimum requirement of experience, which should be 3 years post your qualification. And a post your qualification, 1 year of experience should be in recent 3 years, which is a mandatory requirement. So post your qualification, which how many numbers of experience you have, that will be helping you out to increase the points criteria. And once we have this eligibility, and if you have a relevant degree for the electronic trade works with the diploma qualification, we can file up for your nomination under skill assessment. When we say skill assessment, your profile would be assessed by an assessing authority called TRA, which is Trade Recognition Australia, where they would assess your profile based on your qualification and experience. And if you are meeting this electronics qualification level and minimum requirement, we have to provide your educational documents, your employment documents. Along with employment documents, you need to provide your payment evidence proof like pay slips and bank statements. And if you've been in any of other countries where you've been paid for the tax, any of our taxation documents would be needed as a part of a skill assessment. This is all to prove that you are a paid employee. After collating these all documents, and we have to file your nomination, you have to file your application for skill assessment, where we would be needing an application to be created on behalf of you, or a program to be filed under nomination for the skill assessment, where a minimum fees what they charge for the processing is 1,028 Australian dollars as a cost of the skill assessment. Along with that, the minimum processing time they take is 3 months to give you the results on your skill assessment. Successfully receiving outcome from skill assessment from the TRA, which is Trade Recognition Australia, will make you to eligible to file your next stage, which is expression of interest, where you have to show your interest to file the visa. As I initially told, this is based on your qualification experience. That points calculation comes under the second stage, where you show your express to file your visa. And if you're meeting the minimum criteria of 65 points and the state nomination criteria, we would be eligible to file for your application along with the state nomination. Once we have the positive invites from a department or from a state nomination, we go to the last stage, which is visa, where you would be including your documents, your family members, immediate family members documents into the application. And we have to be, there is a specific fee for the visa processing at the PR stages, we still have to be paid. After we complete the payment, we would have to complete your medical test and the PCC for the dependents. PCC is nothing but the police clearance certificate for the wherever you have stayed in recent 10 years or above in last 10 years. If you have stayed in any country more than 12 months or continuously or cumulatively, you have to give the PCC for people who are above 18 years in the application. And medicals to be done for all the dependents like spouse and kids if they are included in the application. Once we file the application and wait for the decision, and once the decision is made, then the visa would be valid for 5 years from the date of receipt of grant. And after receiving the grant, then you can fly to Australia to achieve your dreams. If you are interested to check with your eligibility to apply for this trade workers, I would request you to send us and reach out us on a WhatsApp. We are available on WhatsApp number on 058-232349. And if you want to send us an email to check your eligibility and send you this report, we would be needing you to send us an updated CV for a group, which is dubai@aussizz.com. I hope that you might have liked this video. If you have liked this video, please subscribe our channel for day-to-day updates or any updates in related to Australian immigration process. Thank you. Have a great day.